Hi everyone, I'm back with another review of some of the videos of the budgies. I think I left off at review number 4, which was Victor. So I'm just going to continue on from there. We're approaching the middle of August 2020, and the angels are hoping that August is the month that people start stepping up and helping out, and where we can begin to get this religion on the map. During my last presentations, which finished off at presentation 70, we had some pretty amazing song reversals. I'm not going to stop there. As I do these reviews, I'm going to try and add another song reversal to each review that I do. So what I'm going to do at the end of this review, it would be something new for the people that have seen most of the other presentations, and kind of make it a little bit different. A lot's happened since my last presentation. Linda and Kayla moved to our new place, in which is about 100 miles from here, and I'm working, and when I'm off, I go up there until I retire. So I've decided that for at least the rest of the month of August, I'm going to put a little bit of effort into going into some of the reviews of the videos. I think they're quite helpful in trying to get people to understand what the budgies were saying, and hopefully you'll find them interesting. So in my last presentation, I left off in my reviews at part 4, the SuperConscious Bird part 1. So now I'm going to go to review SuperConscious Bird part 2, which is on in presentation 7 right here. Let's see if we can get that lined up properly. So in the first part of this SuperConscious Bird part 2, in number 1 and 2, Victor talks about how there'll be many people coming with their questions, so it's another prophecy, and how there's a new system, and how I'll prove the point. And I think he means, because of the way the song reversals are happening, there's no way that I could have manipulated any of the songs that have been up on the internet. If people think I somehow manipulate them or do reverse masking with them, they shouldn't, because that's not possible for these songs. And then he says, don't you think it's nice to hear that I can prove the point? And he also talks about how there'll be an easy way to function with the visionaries that come here, the new visionaries, and telling it all.
Look this way, Victor.
So there was a lot of fast talking in that one by Victor. If you slow it down, let's see now. I remembered I could do this in the last one that I did, but now because I'm not on YouTube, I can't slow it down. So I might have to go to the YouTube to do that. So here we are on YouTube, and I'll click on settings. I'll play it back at 75%, and then we'll just play that part over again.
Look this way, Victor.
Thank you. also talks about quantum reverse again in that one. So in that last part, he talked about how we'll resolve an easy way with the visionaries, telling it all. And I think he is referring to how he made some rules for the forum about how if there are problems in the forum, that we'll be able to, you know that the angels will know what's going on, and they'll be more or less the ones that guide us in who is actually there for helping us and who's there to cause problems. And then he goes on after that in the next part, talking about how there will be people in the forum that are there because they have religious evil, and they'll try to cause problems because they will never have any belief in something different than what they currently believe in. So let's play that part. So he talks about, and I know why I've got it in slow motion there, and it kind of sounds strange, but he talks about how some people will come in and pretend to help as well, which we've had happen before, and then just cause problems. And then when you question them or tell them to stop doing something that is kind of breaking the rules of the forum, they'll claim, they'll be like a victim and then try and get people on their side. So that's another thing that he talks about and foresees happening with people in the forum. So there's a whole bunch of these things that are important in this part of the this video, how is really prophetic in his understanding of how people are and how the angels know that many of these things will happen. In the next part, he talks directly to somebody, and I think at one point somebody may question him on, it's only an act, it's something that he's been taught. And then he says, if I only came to act here, then you'd at least agree that you can more or less understand what I'm saying. Because a lot of people will come on and say, I can't understand a thing. The people that want to cause problems saying that he's not talking, he's just, chirping things out. And then after that, he talks about, so if you can at least admit that that he's a, you can understand what he's saying, then this film must be precious. Because so how could a bird learn how to do this and say these things? And so it's pretty interesting what he's about to talk about in this next part. So I'm going to go back and play that in, so sometimes I don't know how far I can go back here, but I'm going to play it in regular speed. I might be able to understand that one a little bit better, and it doesn't sound so strange. Let me see here. Let's try it from here. Yeah. So I know that some of you might think that a lot of this reversals that I'm putting my own words in here, if you can't understand it, because a lot of it is very difficult to understand it, and I realize that. But when you get to the song reversals that I do, they seem to be a lot clearer because they're human speech. So you're not only trying to understand bird language here, but their language in reverse, which is it's even more complicated than hearing human reversals, quantum reversals. So if you can hear any of these reversals at all, then you're doing good. And if you listen close enough with headphones and go over it enough, you'll be able to hear a lot of what I hear. So in this next part, he talks about how this study is different. And if people come here looking to hassle others and try and affect, you know, everything we do, then they'll mention it. And what they mean is the angels will mention it. And if some people come to, he says, eat what I've grown, then they'll get the call. And he says, here, Earth calls someone who gets to learn. Some people will come here because they're called to learn about God and learn the truth. So let's play that next part. And then he talks about how he knows right now how you're here. In other words, he's actually, this is an angel speaking. And anyone that comes here, the angels know why they're here. And they'll call the right people to be part of this. And if you've got goodness in your heart and you've got belief and you're excited about this, then you will be called by them. In the next part, he talks about how to defeat the challenges, and that there'll be some there that come are like a kitty cat that meow each time someone talks. And those people are here more for promoting themselves, and they might need moderation and they might need some guidance. And if there's people that, and then he talks about how if there's people that are escorted by evil, that they'll point them out. And if they point them out, then you'll know too, deep down in your soul as well, that who's being truthful and who's not being truthful. And because this is a very important thing that's going to change the world. And the angels want to make sure that people are ready for it and that people understand it, and we don't have issues like we've had before in forums where we get somebody that try to take over or cause problems. So I think you really have to understand that there's so much here that you can learn from this, and how the angels can communicate through birds and communicate through songs. Can tell the future, can make prophecy, and how they can guide us, and all these things are so important for humanity's future, especially in this time in age, and definitely need these changes. And that's why this is an important part. And it might sound like it's a little bit demanding, but we have to make sure that something as important as this gets the respect that it deserves. So let's play that part.
Yeah.
And he's actually answering the questions. He says, you know, how will you know who is truthful? And then he answers the questions. In this next part, he talks about how there will be people that will wholly support and welcome what we're doing. And they will have knowledge and help. However, if there's people that come that say that you know, no matter what, I'll never believe anyway, and I won't even want to think about it, then there's not really any reason at this point to have them involved. Maybe later on, once they realize and think about some of the things that we've tried to teach them, come to be in their lives, then they might want to come back here. But they'll be given warnings, and those that, when they are warned, and they try to, you know, cause issues, they should just be ignored in the beginning, given warnings, and then, you know, because they want to make the angels want this to be a better place, and they want to be able to develop it. He also talks about how people will know who are spewing the insults, you know, or cracking jokes, or, you know, trying to be sarcastic and things like that. Let's hear that part. So in this next part, he asks another question. Maybe somebody asked it, and we had this issue once before, where all the people in the forum, instead of trying to learn what was being taught, took over with talking about parrots and parrot intelligence, and didn't really look at the spiritual aspect of things. And so the question he asks, is it okay here to discuss parrots? And then the answer is, it will depend. There'll be some discussion, but there's a reason to get on with the important stuff learned. We think you should take what you've learned and protect it to intercept evil infiltrating as a stream. So let's hear that part. I'm going to play that again, because there's a lot of really fast talking in that. And I'll play it slower. So he doesn't want evil infiltrating with lies that open up a culture. He talks about how, in the next part, he talks about how they cross that all the time when a rival decides to question what's actually done, what we're doing, and how God sees how I run the mission and accepts what I'm doing. Just play it back to put it back to normal speed there. And then he talks about how you can trust that Victor picks him. It's just kind of cute. I've had to deal with a lot of forgiveness in the past 20 years with things that have happened to me in forums and things like that. And I do forgive everyone, and I don't hold any grudges for anything. And that's just my nature. You know, I'm not perfect, but and I have my faults, but I don't hold grudges or carry anger with me about some things that's happened in the past. And I think that's important that people know that forgiveness is a cure for many things, and it helps us in our lives, and the angels know that what our soul is like, and how we can forgive. And when you do go to heaven, if you had people in your life that you caused you harm in the past, and they somehow made it to heaven, they changed and somehow made it to heaven, you can't hold grudges in heaven. You have to forgive them. And if you don't have forgiveness in your heart when you go to heaven, then that's evil, and that's part of spiritual evolution that you need to gain before you can actually make it to heaven. Well, let's play this next part, or let's play this next part. So he talks a little bit about how some of the things happened in the past with me, and even when I was shown showing people how prophetic things were happening and having confirmations, and I still got a lot of people who casted discontent with every step I had, and insulted me a lot. So that's just something else that he's foreseen, and more prophecies that have happened. And the next part, well, let's play it first, and then I'll talk about it after. That was kind of interesting. When he said, when you just attack someone, you're just a sad soldier.
Tell me a joke, Victor.
Then he talks about how I've got a cause to worry, given what the angels want of me, and it's a lot of responsibility. And even though I've known a lot of, you know, the communications that have been going on, and try my best to move things forward, that it goes pretty slow, and it's not an easy task.
Have you got a joke for Ryan?
No, he talks about if I was having erosion in my life, in other words, if my spirits were getting low in life because of supporting them, and in a case where I had thousands of people that were interested in the parintelligent aspect of it, and I dropped it all for the spiritual aspect of what the angels were saying and what the budgies were communicating through the angels, and then they say, well, what do you tell them? What do you tell me to help, relieve the suffering that I went through, and this is what he comes up with.
Yeah.
He says that the whole thing's going to get better as you'll see the reversals of evil, and he continues on with. I'll play that back again.
Have you got a joke for Ryan? Tell us your fart joke.
Sorry about that. It's kind of a silly thing to say, but Victor, in the beginning, made a few funny fart jokes. And if you listen to some of his funny videos, he talks about, you know, things like that. And he joked a lot about people food, how people, if you want to listen to one of his funny ones, it's called People Food, you know, what people eat and how birds see it and stuff like that. It was really funny. And that one, the funniest one that I liked was where he laughed, and he could laugh just like a human. And it wasn't any laugh that, like, I'd never laughed like that, not anybody I knew ever laughed like that. He developed his own way of laughing, which was quite amazing. And when he laughed, it was just hilarious. So that was an important comment he made about how the prophecy that I'm about to bring a different future. And early on, when I first started hearing Victor saying it, I thought, you know, it's not possible. How could I be, you know, chosen to do something like that? But as the years progressed, and as I was hearing other budgies say it, and, you know, two other budgies, Mailer and Danny, say it, and then the song reversals are saying it as well, I can't deny it anymore. No matter how much I try and say, you know, I'm, what if I got a hero complex or something, I can't, you know, keep on hearing these things without really taking them seriously and having this religion and believe that this religion will be something that will help change the future. He's talking about, and that's another important statement about how the future may exist in this channel to us. In other words, there might not be a future unless humanity changes and starts using the angels to guide them away from total destruction and annihilation. Let's carry on.
What'd you say? Put the what?
And he talks about how the future caused Victor to talk. In other words, again, time travel, angels can travel back and forth in time. He sees the future, and the future affects him, and the future is trying to affect us. And in heaven, there is no time and space, and the eternal soul isn't affected by it.
Hell with the passenger.
That's another thing too, another prophecy that came true, and you'll see that a lot of the videos do have something living in them. Danny's videos would, you know, come up with amazing stuff. He'd say certain things before they would happen. And Victor had that ability as well. Mailer was able to have know what people were going to say in forums before they actually said it. And you can always find something special in the videos that shows you that there is some phenomena happening in the video itself. And then he talks about how the miracle will be repeated, and I think that that could mean one of two things. It could mean how the quantum reversals are being done through songs, or when the new group of budgies come, how they'll be able to communicate in the same way and prophesy in the same way.
Finally, we are going to finish this video off with the newest song Quantum Reversal Ryan transcribed. It is called Dance Monkey. It is the official version that is up on YouTube. In this version, at the beginning and end, there is some talking that is part of the reversal, so you should watch the forward version if you get a chance. Dance Monkey is a song by Australian singer Tones and I, released on May 10, 2019. It's amazing that this song that Ryan more or less randomly chose fits perfectly into this review, as if it was made for it.
Yes.
This completes this presentation. If you like what you see, please subscribe to our new Sentinels of the Future channel, which has all the latest presentations in one place, or visit our website at theangelscrolls.com.